Shot it going out of the team. 3500 for D. Shed, please.
Yo, what is good, Villain World? Man, y'all already know who it is. It's that kid, man. HBK Villain Thug, man, the one and the only. And y'all, the other just, man, they be faking and baloney. Y'all already know how we rocking. Yes, sir, G. Yes, sir, man. If y'all living up under a tree or up under a rock, man, it's time to get this thing ready to rock. You did? Like, hey, college football season is here this week, man. It is here this week. But guess what, though? I ain't even get to tell y'all. See, y'all get to see the ranking. Like, we ain't even get to get in the rankings for real. Every year, you got Alabama at number one. This year, bro, they put Oklahoma at number two. I don't know how I really feel about that, man, but it's all good. Then you got Clemson at number three, Ole State at four, Georgia at five. You feel me? It's all good, man. They got UGA at five, Texas A&M at six in the nation. Even though, you know, they did beat us last year, bro, but they had Kellen Mond was a seasoned vet. That's the only reason why they beat us, bro. But hey, it's all good. You got Iowa State at number seven, Cincinnati at eight, Notre Dame at nine, and North Carolina at 10. Hey, this is really crazy to see that they kind of mixing it up. But then let's keep on going. We got Oregon at number 11, Wisconsin at 12, and they got us at 13. So these folk put, it's all good, bro. Hey, we not gonna trip. My Florida Gator fans, y'all know how we rocking, bro. Y'all know how we coming, bro. We don't even gotta talk about this year. I don't wanna say nothing this year, bro. I really wanna just do reaction vids, but you know, I gotta watch me some Florida Gators, bro. I don't care about nothing. No outside teams. Maybe we'll do reaction videos on the outside teams, bro. But my Florida Gators, I'm watching every game. And we tuned in week three. Everybody on the tube better be tuned in week three if you got something to say about the Florida Gators. You feel me? So it's all good. We'll stay at 13. It's all good. Then you got Miami right behind us at 14. USC at 15. LSU at 16. And that's really crazy how they got LSU beat us. LSU wasn't that bad, bro. They just had a lot of dropouts. You know what I'm saying? Everybody was like, they ain't want to play, but they got heat, bro. Like, we ain't going to act like LSU is, we ain't going to play with LSU no more. Just know when they come to the Swamp, we go to the Death Valley. It is what it is. Like, we're going to have to put it on them boys. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. But you got Indiana at 17. Iowa, my Iowa Hawkeyes at 18. You did. You got Penn State, 19. Washington, 20. Then you got Texas right at 21, even though they jit from Alabama. Like, Steve Sarkisian. He going to dial something up. I think Texas, they a little underrated this year. Then you got Coastal Carolina at 22, even though they finished the season excellent last year. Louisiana, they finished excellent. You got Utah and Arizona State to really finish the top 25. How I really feel, though, they got over here, you can see the coaches poll. If you look over here at the coaches poll, it's a little different. The coaches poll rank is a little different. They got us at number 11, but it's still kind of the same jibber jab. Like, Iowa's at 18 still. You know, Texas at 19 instead of 21. You got Washington in there. You got Oklahoma State. Hey, shout out to Oklahoma State boys. You feel me? Shout out USC. You feel me? But I feel like they tried Oklahoma State. Bro, their defense last year was the reason why they was ranked even so high. You feel me? Like, they was ranked, I believe, high last year. And then I feel like they really tried Ole Miss. See, we played Ole Miss, I believe, to start the season off last year. And them boys was putting up points. Even though they lost, Elijah Moore. They lost Yeboah. They tight end, bro. That's key pieces. But Lane Kiffin is a offensive mastermind over there, bro. They almost beat Alabama, but they didn't have the defense for it. They had the points, but they didn't have the defense. If they had the defense, bro, they would have won, bro. So, we looking at the 2020 season. I don't really know if we can judge this 2021 season, and that's the reason why these rankings is like this in the first place. I feel like they kind of judged Florida by their 2020 season, and they looking at it like we don't got Kyle Trash or Kyle Pitts or Kadarius Toney, Trayvon Grimes. But I mean, that's key pieces, bro. But I don't feel like we gonna miss a beat, bro. And you know why I feel like that, bro? Emory Jones, even. But we ain't gonna talk about it. But I like the Arizona State. They right outside 25. I don't think Utah should be ranked ahead of them. I feel like Arizona State, you know, that Arizona State USC game, that first game for them was the judging point for the rest of the season for them. Because, you know, they only played with like 6-7 games out there. So, hey, that kind of hurt them, even though they was beating USC the whole game. That was a tough game. But if you're looking at these rankings, bro, like, how y'all feel about them, man? Let me know. Drop a comment. Let me know something. I just want to let y'all know, bro, college football is back, bro. Hey, we even got college revamp. They supposed to be dropping the Boise update soon. The Mountain West update soon. So we got a lot of heat coming, man. Hey, we also had a bunch of transfers come in, come out. So, hey, maybe we could talk about that real quick. Hey, so if we really looking over here, we got some just they left. We got some just that stayed. Like James Houston left us, went to Jackson State. We got a Daquan Newkirk, a D tackle, he here. We got an Antonio Valentine, they was talking about from Penn State, he here. We got a Jace Christman, he a kicker. We done lost a kicker, you know what I'm saying? We done lost CJ McWilliams, he's gone, I'm glad. You know, he wasn't really doing nothing anyway. You got Boateng, he came from Clemson, a tackle. Jadarius Perkins, he done left Missouri, done came to the Gators. We got Elijah Blaze, he done came, and he came from Texas A&M. He coming to play with the Gators. All right, so we gonna pick up right here, man. It says 21 key instant impact transfers for 2021. You feel me? So we gonna check these out. And so what we got right here, you got Mackenzie Milton. Yo, Mackenzie Milton leaving UCF to go to Florida State. That's tough right there. Hendon Hooker, you know, it's a Tennessee from VT. So, ooh, now that's tough right there. So it look like the Tennessee Vols, man, them boys got them a good quarterback now. Charleston Rambo, he going to Miami. He from Oklahoma. I remember hearing his name. Tykeet Smith going to Georgia from West Virginia. Mike Jones from he going to LSU from Clemson. I remember his name. Then you got a Jake Cohn from Wisconsin. He going to Notre Dame. Linebacker Ben Davis going to Texas from Alabama. That's key right there now. That's key. I'm telling y'all, Steve Sarkisian got something going on over there, Texas, man. We got a wide receiver, Wandell Robinson, Kentucky from Nebraska. So, hey, Nebraska done lost them a big threat. On to the top 10, you got Charlie Brewer. He going to Utah from Baylor. I know y'all know Charlie Brewer. He in a nice quarterback now. Keontae Ingram going to USC from Texas. Keontae Ingram, I believe he the what? Was he the one who tried to jump over somebody? Got his ass cracked? I'm not sure. Number 8, Ty Chandler. He leaving Tennessee. He going to North Carolina. Running back. Oh, he a threat, boy. He nasty. All right, here we go. We at the top 5. You got Eric Gray leaving Tennessee to go to Oklahoma. He's nice. Linebacker. Toa Toa. He leaving Tennessee to go to Alabama. Ooh. Nah, that's tough. And last but not least, the biggest transfer of them all is Tyler Shaw, I believe. That's like Tyler Shaw. But, hey, that man leaving Oregon. I remember him. He going to Texas Tech, though. And that's in a bit to us, so we ain't got to worry about it. But he all right, though. Yeah, that's going to wrap up week 0 coverage, man, over here at V-Long World, man. Y'all boy want to come in, check in. Y'all want to talk about who y'all think going to go for the win, who y'all think y'all got winning. Hey, I ain't even going to lie. Let's do some little predictions, though. What y'all want to do? Y'all want to do a prediction? So, hey, we gonna bring this thing back up on Tuesday next week, and we're going to talk about week 1. I don't want to show y'all too much of week 1 coverage, but we're going to do this right here, man. We're going to do who y'all think going to win. I like Nebraska for the win right here. I like Nebraska here. Week 0, I like Nebraska. I like Fresno State over UConn. I ain't gonna lie. I definitely like Hawaii over UCLA. Because, boy, UCLA, they struggling with Chip Kelly. I don't know why. And then I like New Mexico State over UTEP. I don't know why. But then I got San Jose State, man. So, hey, y'all let me know who y'all think gonna win. Put in the comments who y'all think gonna win. Y'all already know who it is, man. It's the HBK, if you don't throw it, man. I'm out, G.